Hi friends, welcome to Crack Great B. We are back with yet another important lecture continuing the current affairs series that we are running out in our YouTube channel. Right, so we bring out to the current affairs from 16 and 17 November 2021. Right, so let's begin with the first news article, that is key initiative for the welfare of Janjatiya communities. Right. So the Prime Minister launched multiple key initiatives for the welfare of Janjatiya community at Janjatiya Gaurav Divas Mahasammelan. Okay, and what he has launched? Ration Aapke Gram scheme in Madhya Pradesh, and he also launched the Madhya Pradesh Sickle Cell Mission. You will have to remember this. Then Prime Minister has also laid foundation stone of 50 Eklavya Model Residential School. So, you know, this EMRS are in lines with the military school, but these are not military school. These are these schools are under the Ministry of, you know, Tribal Affairs, and these are mostly for the people of tribe, so that, you know, they can come to the mainstream economy and get the education of that level. Okay, so the Prime Minister has approved and have inaugurated 50 Eklavya Model School in 27 districts, 7 states, 1 UT through virtual mode from the capital of Madhya Pradesh, that is Bhopal. Right. So let's move to the next news article, index number for WPI, Wholesale Price Index. So in the coming section, for someone who is preparing new for the RBI SEBI on NABARD, please do mention, like, if you know who releases WPI data, right? So this is your task in for the coming section. Then the annual rate of inflation is 12.45 provisional for the month of October. Okay, and why this was high? This was high due to the rise in price of mineral oil, basic metals, food products, crude petroleum, and etc. So among the major item, other than this, who have where it was price rise was the fruit, from 4.47% in September to 8.14% in October. Okay, so let's move to next news article, that is India and ADB had signed a $61 million loan. So this loan is with the government of India, Asian Development, right? But this is key. This loan is for Agartala city to improve livability, harness technology, and promote new development to accommodate the expanding population in Agartala city while building capacity of state's agency for improved service delivery. Through this project, ADB will catalyze synergies with the smart city. So basically, you know, it's about the development of that Agartala city as a smart city. This loan has been signed between Government of India plus ADB and the state government. So whenever you see there is a loan between any state government and the intergovernmental body, the Government of India is in between, right? So let's move to the next news article, that is nationwide EHDF KCC Kisan Credit Card campaign launch. This is very important news, because to, as a part of Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, this campaign was officially launched by the Shri Purushottam Rupala. Now, what is the idea behind this initiative, right? In order to expand the benefit of Kisan Credit Card to all eligible animal husbandry, dairy, fishery farmer in the country, right? So, see, Kisan Credit Card, when you think of farmer, you first think of farmer in the field. But the definition of farmer is not limited to field, right? The people who are involved in livestock production or animal husbandry, you can say, and in the fisheries, in Hindi it says machli palan, right? So all these people are, who are engaged here are also called farmers, okay? Also called farmers. So these people, you know, are mostly deprived from the facilities of Kisan Credit Card. In order to get them onboarded, this particular scheme is launched, and this is not a scheme, this is a campaign. This campaign is from 15 November 2021 to 15 Feb 2022. Okay, so this is a very long campaign. Government is hoping that good number of eligible farmers coming on board and getting the benefit of Kisan Credit Card. Right, livestock sector. And now, why, you know, government is keeping an eye on this farmer is because this livestock sector is crucial to the Indian economy today, comprising 1/3 of the agriculture and elite sector GVA having over 8% CAGR. 1/3 of the agriculture. So the contribution of agriculture in the GDP is somewhere around 18%. Right? If you see 1/3, it's 6%. Right? So this is the contribution of livestock sector. And this is very important. Now, at the same time, animal husbandry, dairy, and fisheries activities play a significant role in generating farmers' income, particularly among the landless, small and marginal farmers and women, besides providing cheap and nutritious food to millions of people. Right? So, let's move to the next new article, that is number 5. Center's tax devolution to state doubles. So, Union Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman said, the center would release double the monthly amount of tax devolution, a total of rupees 95,082 crore in November, to enable the state to step up their capex and spur economic growth close to double digit this fiscal year. The states were to be given rupees 47,541 crore in November, in line with the 15th Finance Commission formula of the 41% devolution from the central taxes. So you know that so the central government earns tax of rupees 100, the 41% is to be given to, or is to be distributed, or is to be devolved to all these states, among these states, right? Now, the states were given 47,541 crore in November. Okay, the finance minister is saying that the amount is doubled. The center would release double the monthly amount of tax devolution, a total of 95,082 crore in November. Okay, and she wants that the state should also step up their capital expenditure. Now, capital expenditure has a ripple effect in the economy. That's why every government is looking forward for a capital expenditure, right? So, with this, let's move to the next news article, that is currency in circulation. So, as per the SBI research, currency in circulation is somewhere around 43,900 crore during the Diwali week in 21, more or less stagnant compared to 43,800 crore in a year ago during this period. So there is no more, you know, jump. As many as 3.5 billion transactions and 6.3 trillion were recorded through UPI in the month of October 2021. So you see, this is way much higher than even it was projected, right? Representing a jump of 100% in the volume transaction and nearly 103% in a year-on-year basis, right? UPI transaction has jumped 69 times since 2027. So this is it is because of the ease of use in the UPI and also adaptability. Now you see metro, let us consider tier 2 and tier 3 city. Even in tier 2 and tier 3 city, people are ready to accept 5 rupees in their using the scanner, using the Paytm, phone pay, means the UPI. Okay. Maybe they do not know the UPI, they know Paytm, they know phone pay, that's it. They do not know the technology behind it, that's UPI. So UPI is widely accepted anywhere in India as of now. So that's the reason this jump, 69 times jump. So it should have been jumped more, the currency in circulation would have come down. Okay, and you know the currency in circulation is way high as of now, because when there was lockdown, the national lockdown, people were keeping cash with themselves to meet any external exigencies, right? From the health perspective, because most of the people were in fear, and during the second wave also, many people had COVID. So they do not wanted any last minute acceptancy of the online payment. So people were more into keeping cash. Let's move to the next news article. Okay, so there are more reports into this. After dipping 8.7% of GDP post demonetization, means currency in circulation. The currency in circulation as a percent of GDP has climbed again. However, this could partly be concentration to GDP's 7.3% during FY21. Okay, the effect is also evident in GDP in the current financial year. Meanwhile, tax to GDP ratio jumped. So when tax to GDP ratio jumps, this does mean that even if people are doing the cash transaction, having cash in their hand, they are paying taxes. Because the logical conclusion is that. And rest, if you want to get into the data, you can find out the trend, like keeping a cash and not paying the taxes or something like that. Right? Now, let's see this in the data as well. Look, the transaction when the UPI is launched in 2017, the kind of jump it sees. Let's move to the next news article, that is Open Door Report. So this is a report published in the United States about the number of students getting admitted to the colleges and universities of United States. So there has been a decline of 15% in the number of international students in the US in the year 2021 because of the COVID, as simple. Why? Because people got admission that time, but they were asked to study from home, from their respective country. And that was not the as a psychological factor. One is studying in the United States in that country, and one is sitting in the country like India, China, or Africa and reading online in their home. So there is no touch and feel of that country. So that's the reason there is a decline, as against a decline of 1.8% in 1920, shows the latest Open Door Report 21. Then the highest annual decline of 15% of the US came amid countries affected by the waves and variant of COVID-19 pandemic, impacting international travel and overseas education. Okay, so from the data of India and China, which accounts for 53% of the total international student in the US, now you see, if 100 students is admitted to school, colleges and universities of United States, 53 are from China and India alone. There have been decline of 15%, 13% respectively. The number of annual Chinese student accounting 35% of the total international student in the US fell to 317,299. India comprises nearly 20% of the overseas student in the US, with 1,67,582 in the 2021 academic year. Okay, way less. Then let's move and let's see the data. So this is the number of students in the US. So China is at number one, India number two, South Korea, Canada, Saudi Arabia. So every country is in negative territory. Let's move forward to the next news article. A report by the United Nations High Commissioner for Refugee. Okay, see, this report is about the internal displacement. Let us understand what is internal displacement. Internal displacement means you are leaving your home, but not your country. Okay, a good example that I can remember now is Kashmiri Pandit. They were forced to leave, leave their homes in Jammu and Kashmir, but they were not flown to out of India, right? So they are now settled some of the other parts of India. This is called internal displacement. Log bahar nahi ja rahe. Because many a time, reading this type of report, when we know what happened in Afghanistan few days back, we might tend to compare. So what happened in Afghanistan? Yes, there are internal displacement, Agreed. But more of an external displacement. Most of the people were flown out of the country. Many people have become refugee to another country. Many people have traveled to Jordan, right? Many people have traveled to Iran. Many people have traveled to Pakistan. Many people have came to India. Many people were taken to United States. Many people were taken to Europe. This is called external displacement. But let's say somebody living on the capital city of Afghanistan is now left that city and is on a different city in Afghanistan. So that is internal displacement. As many as 50.9 people were internally displaced across 33 countries due to conflict and violence in the first 6 months of 2021. Okay, irrespective of COVID, you see violence was at peak. 50.9 people were internally displaced across 33 countries. Now, so this is million, okay? 50.9 million. Now, Africa was the country which is affected the most. Okay, so let's move forward with the next news article, that is Pochampally village in Telangana. Okay, this is the first initiative by the United Nations World Tourism Organization. This initiative is known as Tourism Village by UNWTO. Okay, this aims to award those villages which were outstanding example of rural destination and showcase good practice in line with the specified, sorry, 9 month, 9 valuation area. The 9 parameters they were judged. Ministry of Tourism has recommended, you know, these 3 villages from India for the award, who will get award on 2nd December 2021 in Madrid, Spain. Okay. So these villages were one of the villages from Meghalaya, one from Madhya Pradesh, and one from Telangana. And eventually, Pochampally was awarded. Right? With this, we have come to the end of this lecture. We wish you very good luck from Team CrackBB. Thank you and happy learning.